on TonyDUrso.com/radio and other places. You will see him. You got to check out this lady. She's hot. She's awesome.
Thank you. I appreciate Tony.
My pleasure. And we've got a few more minutes, but perhaps you'd like to, you know, I want to make sure that you let the audience know anything important that you'd like to let the audience know. Please take your time. And what else would you like to make sure we know about?
Okay, great. I would actually like to say that because I am someone who is really big on people fulfilling their purpose and their mission, understanding that everything in your life serves a purpose and it truly can be transformed into your greatest ventures ever. And it's really time to take the limits off of yourself and find your edge and go beyond that edge. And if you're in business, I would really like to encourage you to start owning your true value and loving yourself enough to start working on building the eight-figure self first versus a six- or seven-figure or even eight-figure business. I have learned that if your self-worth doesn't vibrate at the level that it needs to, then it won't make much difference even if you have a perfect seven- or eight-figure business model. And the eight-figure self has more to do with honoring who you are, valuing who you are, loving who you are, and it's so much more than numerics. So if you embody those three virtues, then a seven- or eight-figure business will evolve from you just as an extension of your own unique expression.
Very cool. And I, you know, I've never thought of an eight-figure business. I've thought of seven figures, and I've done seven-figure sales and seven figures, you know, I've done that, been there, done that. But I've never set my sights on eight figures, and it just came to me that eight, if you put it on its side, is infinity. And so I kind of, something about it indicates, and I like that. It's like you're really going to infinity and beyond. That eight is very cool. So I'm changing my business to eight digits.
But the focus is, the primary focus is becoming the eight-figure self, which really, if I had to break that down, that really goes back to holistic prosperity, because it's really not about the numbers. It's really about your self-worth, of how you show up, how you're treating yourself, because only how you treat yourself is how you treat others. You know, value everyone and treat everyone as if, you know, they are worth millions and beyond. When you treat everyone like they are the most important person on the planet, you will then reciprocate that energy. You'll receive it back to yourself. And being the eight-figure self is a person, their whole essence is just valuable. And it will translate into being able to build that type of business. But most teach it the other way around. They want to teach you how to build a seven- or eight-figure or six-figure business, but they've yet to focus on the person of becoming a master at being themselves. It doesn't matter what your business model is or the frameworks. If you haven't yet cultivated that type of essence for yourself, you'll never pull off a six- or seven-figure business model.
I got you now. Okay, I read that loud and clear, Alicia, and yes, makes great, great sense. It's sort of like setting the foundation of the building. It's got to be in right, because you could build a skyscraper, you could build 10-floor building, very poor materials, and you could get 10 floors, you know, you could get your financial goal, in other words, there's the parable, there's the analogy. But if that foundation isn't strong, it's all going to come crashing. Yet if you have strong base and you're good with others and you treat them well and you treat them like you expect to be treated and you have that integrity and honor, you're building a strong base, and that 10-floor building is going to withstand anything and everything.
Absolutely. It will sustain long term.
Well, great. Well, thank you very much for sharing that, Alicia. It's been wonderful. It's been great. I've enjoyed so much having you on, and I think we've only touched